And again, so do a leg heel together across the stool. Stay rising, don't sit. Right, don't sit if he's lazy. Make him quicker. So left side straighter. So there, right, when I see you go sideways, to me, he doesn't push forward and over, he falls out his outside shoulder. So I see him fall to the side rather than thinking upright. So think now, keep the right side straighter, don't bend the neck. Keep the neck straighter. Go on, right rein. Right rein. Make him almost look a little bit to the outside. There you go. Good. And again, do it from the center line this time. Turn. Keep the neck up. Up. Right rein. Look up. You don't look where you're going. That's it. Look up. That's much better. And again. So shorten up your rein. So you're going to turn down the center line and do a C, leg heel from C to V. Right side straight. So that was terrible. Turn around again. Turn around again. Go around and do it again. So, V. So, look at the, start slightly on a diagonal line to V. So turn now, look at your line, turn. Right side straight, much better. See, if you start slightly on a diagonal line into your leg heels, then you've always got the shoulders leading, and then you just keep flowing. So many riders come around and they start straight, and then they push to go sideways, and then they lose the rhythm because they haven't got the shoulders in the right place. Look up. Well done. So if you find it difficult to get him to go sideways, then do it in the leg heel first. So you just teach him to stay up from the shoulders and then pushing sideways from your leg. And again, look up where you're going, keep his neck up, left side straighter. See, now I have the feeling that he's going forward and over, not just falling sideways. Much better, give him a pat. Right, this time you can do it again. But you're going to change the bend to the right. So your leg heel, now change the bend if you're going half cast. So make him look to the right. Make him look right. A bit more. A bit more. Good. Well done. Pattern. And again. And you managed to do that without slowing down. Which is good. That's exactly the same right thing you need to do. Now change the bend. Make him look to the right. Go on, make him look right, a little bit more right flexion. Good. That's it. Then change the rein. So shorten up your reins. So just by doing the leg heel and then changing the bend over into the half pass, that helps because the horse is used to going sideways and then all you're doing is just changing the bend and then you're into your half pass so that then you just keep it flowing. So left side straight, go down the stool, up, bring his neck up a bit more. So shorten your reins and then neck up. That's it, and again, turn, up. Good. Now change the bend to the left. Make him look left. Take his shoulders left. Go on. Take his shoulders to the left. Well done. Good. Once more. So it's definitely easier for you to bend left than to the right. Good. Now change the bend. Up. Go on. Keep trotting. Keep trotting. Keep trotting. Well done. Very good. Right. Change the rein. Let's just actually do a circle down there and then you do a centre line and a half pass back to the track. So, you're going to ride your turn, you're going to keep that neck up, you're going to think of the shoulders going to the left. That's it. Look up. Why are you looking down? There's nothing down there, I can promise you. Right? Look up at where you've got to go. Good. And again, half pass to the right. Think about keeping the same rhythm. Keeping the contact so he doesn't drop down. Right bending. Right bending. Right bending. Good. Go on, make him look a little, take his nose a bit more to the right. Yeah, that looks a little bit like half leg heel again. And again, half pass to the left. So you can see that obviously it's much easier to the left than to the right. So she's going to have to do a much more contact on getting into the left rein, because her left rein is always very loose, so she needs to get push the horse into the left rein, and then make him softer to the right. And again, so hard past right. So now bend him. That's it. And bend him. Good. There. Much better. Keep the bend. Go on. Keep the bend. Yep. Okay. Now just change the rein. Now neck up. Come on, sit up. Good. Now just come on a circle here. And now just bend him to the right on the circle. Think up and forward. That's it. Now just leg yield him a little bit to the left. So because he doesn't actually take much contact into the left, she wants to be able to bend him on the circle and have the feeling of leg yielding him out so that that pushes him into her left rein. So she wants to soften the right rein. So don't push his neck down. That's it, soften with the hand. So you want to take a small flexion to the right and now leg yield him with your right leg to the left. So you keep your left rein. So turn the front in towards me. More. So you push it more sideways. Go on, more sides. Off your right leg. That's it. Go on, turn the front in. It's all right. It's going to the loop. Turn the front in. Turn the front in. Well done. There. Now push it with your right leg. Come on. Get those reactions from those legs again. Otherwise, you're going to go for a good knee hole. Come on. That's it. Good. That's better. Now go large and now just soften your hand. That's it. Bring his neck up. Good. Much better. So that's the feeling you want to have in the hard part, is that when you bend him, that you can make him more supple to the right. Good. Okay, give him a long rein and now just let him stretch. Good. So you want to have the feeling that he drops and then he just takes the hand forward. Good. And I think he's absolutely knackered. Good. Very nice. Okay, then do that on the left side. So our horses work 4 days a week. Our horses work on a Monday and a Tuesday. They hack on a Wednesday, and then they go Thursday, Friday is a schooling session, and then a Saturday is another hacking day, and then Sunday's a complete day off. Before all of our horses are schooled, they go for, the Grand Prix horses go for probably a 20 minute hack. They're then warmed up.
A hack is a trail ride, by the way.
Oh yeah. Yeah, your hack is something different to our hack, I think. We just got told. So our hack is up on the roads and around the fields. And actually, Vallegro goes hacking with a lady who's 76 years old, and that's her pleasure, is that she takes them out on the roads for a good jolly. And, amazing horse that he can allow somebody like that to take him hacking. And
be warm as long as you do it properly.
That was a bad transition. I might be talking, but I'm still watching. So they do a 20 minute hack first, and then they're all warmed up for probably another good 15 minutes, 20 minutes stretching. So we have girls that